Hello everybody, today is a new tying video ongoing, so I'm gonna tie a quick thunder and lightning fishing fly. I hope you're gonna enjoy the video, so let's begin. Okay, so let's start tying. I forgot to mention I'm gonna do a version from, if the pattern description is correct, it's Malone. So it's gonna be interesting version of thunder and lightning. So let's start. Starting with the extra small oval tinsel. And today I don't have my glasses on, so let's see how this goes. Might be a challenge. I'm just gonna remove the keyboard. Okay, so I'm just tying it in the tinsel, securing it below. And just going back. There we are. And then forward again. So, a few turns. I'm gonna aim for 3. Oof, scary without my glasses, I can promise you. And I'm too lazy to get them, they are upstairs. And since it's gonna be a fishing fly, I tie sufficient amount of material so it will hold. There we are. Just gonna remove the leftovers. Enough for another fly, at least, maybe more. So, now to the fun part. Blue silk. I'm gonna go with a bit darker blue, just for the fun of it. Same here, tying it in below, a decent amount to make it robust. Tight wraps backwards. And then forward again. And here I'm starting to build up a bit of the body to give the fly a nice look. Just gonna see where we are. Just gonna add another one. That's it. Going backwards. And then securing the silk. And just tie it in as well. There we go. So now I just cut the leftovers there. Pretty nice. Going back with the thread, building up a bit of foundation where the tail is going to be. Gonna apply some backs there, some clear backs. Oops. So next step, the tail. I wonder where that went. There it is. So tying in the whole part here. Since I'm gonna fish with the pattern, I want it to hold. And there is the tail. Going backwards again. Applying some black wax to the thread. Then it's time for a black ostrich herd. Just making sure to have a nice waxed foundation for the ostrich herd. That's gonna remove the extra material in the front there. So tight wraps. 3 or 4 turns. I'm gonna do a fourth. Oops. Just securing the ostrich herd. Tie in a bit more underneath. And then just pushing it backwards a bit. And then I just gonna cut the leftovers. So today I'm filming with my phone, so please let me know if the quality is better than the other camera. So going back, and then it's tinsel time. So I think I'm gonna go with medium oval tinsel. I think medium is sufficient for this hook size. Then I just strip a bit of tinsel to make it smaller at the tying point. And then just cut that off. Expose the inside. So tight wraps, securing all of that material so it's robust. I'm going to do the body in 2 steps, just to simplify it, since I want to tie in the body hackle here. Then I add the silk in front of it, just to make it a bit easier. So just building up, leveling the body a bit. And in this case, black silk. Same here, tying it in quite a lot, and then securing it underneath the hook forward. There we go. So now it's gonna be strong. just gonna remove that last material. So tight wraps backwards. Same here, working on the body proportions. I just need to tilt it a bit since I don't have my glasses on. I don't see that well. And there we are. So I'm just gonna secure the silk, tying that one in. And then cutting leftovers. So now to the interesting part in this pattern, the body hackle. Red. I like that. So just gonna sort out the tying point there. Gonna wax the thread. You don't want to lose the hackle. Going backwards where I want it. And then just tight wraps, securing that fibers. Gonna tie everything in. There we go. It's gonna hold really good. So then I don't really wanna tie. I'm gonna use silk to level up the body. Yeah, I am. So quite a lot of silk this time then. Bit of wax to the thread. There we go. So just unwinding the silk a bit. Tight wraps going backwards. Let's see if this is sufficient, otherwise I need to tie in more. I need more, but that's not an issue. See, as tight wraps. The silk. It's gonna take a while, but we are in no hurry. It's weekend, and I got some fantastic stickers from Canadian Trout Bum. Yeah, but come on, yeah. And this one I like a lot. And another one. Sorry for the interruption. what is going on the ML350. So let's continue. As you see, I'm running out of silk. So what I do is secure, tight wraps forward, tying it in. There we are. Securing. Going back again. Adding some more silk. I think that's sufficient. Maxing the thread. Same here, just tying it in underneath. A few wraps. Cutting the leftovers. And let's continue. So tight wraps backwards. Didn't add that much really, so let's see. Nah, I need to add more. I want to have nice proportions, so let's continue with even more silk. Lesson learned, bring your glasses when you're tying a fly. So, there we are. Third time. Winding the silk a bit. There we are. Now we can continue forward. Just trying to do a decent body, even though I don't see that well without my tying glasses, but that's no excuse. The body needs to look okay. There we are. Saving that silk for later. So now it's decent for a half blind guy. Tinsel time then. I went with the medium silver, oval silver, and then it's time for the body hackle. Blood Red Cock. So I'm just pulling the fibers backwards. I did double it beforehand. In here, yeah, securing the stem, a few turns of vex thread. Please don't use that crappy pre-vex threads. There we go. Gonna secure everything. There we are. Adding some more banks. So front tackle, yay. But I'm going with Galina today. Tying on the 3 overhook, so yay would be, yeah, I got yay in that size, but come on, for a fishing fly, I don't want to waste that. So I go with Galina, tying that one in. Oops. There we go. Feel the hook point. I know it's really sharp. There we go. Folding the hackle backwards. There we are, just cutting the leftovers of the stem there. Hackles on. Now to the wing. I'm just gonna separate the fibers. I'm gonna show you what I do. I don't like when you're pulling down everything. Not my style. I want the hackle to go around. So just preparing space by putting it to the side, so to say. And then you get the balance in the fly when you're fishing. It will not wobble. Sorry. So, wing. Now to the interesting part. So it's a... red and golden peasant tail with bronze mallet over. So I'm thinking about two red sections. Build the wing as you speak, since it's not that complicated. three fibers, and then three fibers again. And then doing the same on the other side. Put those on there. Two red stripes, and it's the golden pheasant tail for this time. So I'm gonna have like three or four of them. And then a bit more above. Almost the same. There we go. One side ready. Let's go for the other side. Then we can build the wing. There we are. So let's start with one side then. There we are. So, adding the next red part. On. Looks like you had some crap on that foot. Okay, and the last part. And there you have a really nice one. We're gonna do the same on the other side. It's not gonna be that high, but that's not the point anyhow. There we go. First two, and another red one. good. And then the last golden pheasant on top of that. And there we are. So two of those. Let's see how that ties in. So I'm just gonna build up a little bit, as you know. Just wanna level up. Otherwise it's gonna be a bump. And when you put the wing, it's just gonna stand straight up. That's not nice. So, pairing the wing sides. Gonna shorten it a bit. I'm just being careful not tying in anything of the galena, but at least trying. So there we are. Gonna turn it a bit. No sides, eh? Let me see. Red swan, golden pheasant, bronze mallard. Simple pattern. So, mallard time then. Just gonna prepare one for each side. Having a look at my mallard here. So I'm gonna take a section from that one as well. So let me start on my side. Maybe I should start on your side, guys. So I think I'm just gonna adjust the light a bit. I forgot to move one of the lights. Thank you. Now it's better. So you can see the color. Sorry for not thinking of that earlier. Just gonna wet my finger a bit. There we go. So that's gonna vex the thread a bit. Then I can cut all the rest material in the front. There we go. Black and nice. I'm just gonna varnish a bit first. Varnish in place. So I'm gonna let it dry, then cut the leftovers, and then take a picture. So, the fly is done. One of the Maloon versions of Thunder and Lightning. I hope you enjoyed the video. Tomorrow I'm gonna do another one live on YouTube here. So if you got time, make sure to join that live session and ask questions and comment. Yeah, let's have a great time. Otherwise, have a nice weekend and see you in the next video. Bye.